We got different quarterbacks. So we're gonna play season after season with. We're gonna see what we can do. First we're gonna do the career of Taylor Heinicke. Thanks to Lily. Lily, this was his first choice. After we finish the season with Heinicke, we're gonna go do a season with Joshua Dobbs. And then after Dobbs, it's CJ Stroud, I think. And then I think I did one for Brock Purdy and. I know I did one for Kenny Pickett.
Yes.
Got some stuff to do. First game for Taylor Heinicke this season against the Vikings.
Standards, but then again, it is still summer. Either way, the AC is working just fine at US Bank Stadium in the Twin Cities. Today, it's the opener of the 2023 NFL season, as it'll be the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on the Minnesota Vikings. With my good friend Charles Davis in the booth, I'm Brandon Gauden, and the moment has finally arrived, CD. It's time to begin a new NFL season.
Partner, there's no hiding my excitement as I got ready this morning. I could not wait to get here for this game. Imagine what it's like out there on the field for the...
Nothing on the scoreboard, 0-0, as the offense gets ready to take over the football. They run with the All-Pro from a couple of years ago, Jonathan Taylor. And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43. So the 14 yards actually takes him from 143 to the other for first and 10. They run once more with Taylor. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3. And they'll come up second and 7. And now it's a bootleg with Heinicke. A little short pass here taken in by Laporta. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. This now a third and 4. Throwing, Heinicke. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. That's a third down conversion to 24 yards there. Nice play.
So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get open in key situations.
And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, 7 and 8. Now Heineke. This will be swung out wide for Taylor. So they'll get nothing out of that play. And for an 8 now, this drive has been a good mix for passing plays. 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Michael Wilson. And the play.
Successfully.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
And nearly another interception there. That would have been 2 drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw is probably worse than the one he threw the intercept. He's got a man complete. And he's finally taken down, and it's a big game there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. And the play fake, and now Heineke. He holds it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. Adam Thielen, 42 yards. And the Bucs have moved out in front. And when the quarterback drops, so this offense will head back out there. Already an excellent field position thanks to the interception. First and 10, Taylor now. Pushes him over. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Second down, another run with Taylor. And here he'll get it down to the 7. That play gets him 6 yards and sets them up with a first and goal.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? Second and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Jonathan Taylor taking it in from... After an excellent punt, this offense in a tough spot down inside their own 5.
Back near his goal line, here's Heineke.
A short pass here taken in by Laporta. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and it'll be 2nd down.
They go play action. Now Heineke.
The ball away and it falls incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, it was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And he backs it away and it falls down.
That might be the 3rd down stop that they needed because they got a lot of trouble slowing down this offense in the first half. This might be their opportunity to get off the field.
So from their own end zone here, this kicks away. 33 yards is the distance on the punt there. And the Viking. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
A carry by Taylor to start the drive.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
Good yardage there on 1st down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs, keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there.
Holding offense.
So not a lineman, but the tight end instead this time drawing the holding call.
And more what you're getting with tight ends are guys who are much more receiver than blocker. They may be willing, but that might not be their thing. Oftentimes, they'll be the ones getting the penalties.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. On third down, Heinicke. This to Laporta, right side. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. This offense in midseason form here in the opener. It's first and 10. Working out of the gun. Here's Heinicke. That is caught by Laporta. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Heinicke again. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one. Closed quickly and helped force the incompletion.
To throw is Heinicke. Dancing to his left. This pass into the hands of Bellinger. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings' 13-yard line. Off the play fake, Heinicke. Flush to his right. A throw on the run, but that's going to be incomplete.
Martin, I think he's got to be careful as he continues to try to extend plays because he's already been intercepted in this game. And the coverage, they continue to challenge all of his receivers downfield.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, he's been targeted quite a bit on this drive. And finally, I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They slapped the double coverage on him, made it very tough for him to get the ball.
Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Adam Thielen. As the first half is winding down, and the Buccaneers are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. So a good start to the campaign so far for them. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And one of the things we like to hit on every year are the new rule changes. So we got a few for 2023. A lot are procedural, having to do with deadlines and roster construction and such. But two kind of caught my eye too. And now off to the races, down the right side. Inside the 20, Jonathan Taylor. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Jonathan Taylor, already his second touchdown here in this opening. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. They'll run with Taylor to begin the drive. And they're able to get this one across the 35. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Here's a quick throw to Thielen. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and it's second down. Up the middle, here's Taylor. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. 155 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Back to Taylor on first down. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. All altogether, a pretty shaky start to the year for this defense as they defend another first and 10. They go to the ground again with Taylor. And shedding through the tackle. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short. We are through three quarters here on NFL. And we return welcoming you back to Minneapolis. In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. A give for Taylor running right side. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Third and short yardage. Heineke sliding out of the pocket. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert here on third and three. To the right side, this is Taylor. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. Heineke to throw it. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. This offense so far on third down, they've been very good. 5 for 7 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. It in for the Buccaneer touchdown. Mecole Hardman from 6 yards away. And the Bucs are closing in on a win. Now following the interception, this offense will get another shot at it. This will quickly head back onto the field. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down. Running straight ahead, Taylor. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today, and now they're in the hurry up. Play action now. Here's Heineke. Oh, that is incomplete. Complete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Heineke. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
I think it's fairly safe to call this game over, but they're still trying to bomb it downfield and add to their lead. Almost makes you start to feel for the defense and root for them a little bit, too.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Call that a 33-yard punt with no return. And it will be late stages of the game here in the fourth quarter as this offense takes over first and 10. Now a handoff. Taylor with it. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5 to about the 39. Tay Crowder able to make the play. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. Second down and 8. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
The CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, if you're up, you can continue to do what you want to do. It's up to the other team to make you change how you do things. They'll continue to throw it around until stopped.
Well, their passing attack, even though that one was incomplete, has been really sharp in this one. It's resulted in a lot of touchdowns, and it looks like they're not going to stop throwing the football until the very end of this one.
Well, that will certainly make everyone involved on offense pretty happy because that gives them all a chance to pad their stats a bit. But as far as the actual need,
So they surrendered 3 points, and now after the kickoff, this offense gets ready to take over the football. They give to Taylor out of the gun. Down at the 35, it'll be second down.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
Second down, another run with Taylor. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
I think we can safely say that those types of players are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
They'll try and run for the first with Taylor. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. And they're going to speed things up here. That one looks like he'll throw here. Escaping the pressure right. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
They're certainly not letting up on the pressure in this one. And oftentimes you hear this expression, all gas, no break from defenses. But in this case, it's the offense still throwing the football up big in the fourth quarter.
A second down throw for Heinicke. Left side complete to Lockett. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play. So it doesn't affect the outcome, but a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lagniappe, a little extra on top.
Well, CD, I mean, simply put, if anyone around the league wasn't paying attention to them to start the season, they will be heading into week two. This has been an impressive week one performance.
They've certainly announced that they are ready to go, haven't they? They wanted to send a message out to the rest of the league. You better put your eyes on us. We may be someone you have to reckon with.
Well, CD, always a little extra excitement for week one.
233, four touchdowns for Taylor Heinicke, week one.
When Sunday comes to a close, good to be back in the booth with you.
I'll take it.
Just like Diego, God, God, God. Yeah, got a dime piece from she he's doing. That was a really good friend of mine on TikTok. He's one of the first people I found on here. And we always went to eat other people's lives, and we would gift and shit.
I couldn't imagine dropping money on a girl that's never even been with me.
Yeah. Like, there's this one other kid that thinks that he dropped all this money on Star, like, he's gonna get Star. First of all, Star's only had sex twice. She ain't fucking nobody. And she's not even that good looking, bro. She just got big tits, and I hate big tits. If they overload my hand when I grab them, there's an issue. See, Chris, yours are perfect. Mine are perfect.
Perfect. Perfect, Chris, perfect.
That's all you need. Now, yeah.
My money attached.